Welcome to another Marty's Mods tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to use the ReShade injector. If you prefer a written version of this tutorial, check the description below for links to our guide site.
Some games might refuse to load ReShade because of protected launchers or because it is a UWP game. In those cases, we can use the ReShade injector to force ReShade to load into the game. Since it injects a DLL into the process, try to use it only in single player games.
To get started, we need to know the game architecture, if it is a 32 or a 64-bit game. We can find that out either by going to a PC gaming wiki and searching for the game entry, or while the game is open, we can check the process tab in Task Manager. If the game has a 32-bit in its name, then it's a 32-bit process. If it doesn't, it is a 64-bit process. With that information in mind, we need to download the correct injector. We can find links for the injectors on guides.martysmods.com. Link in the description. Download and move the injector to the game folder. After that, we can install ReShade just as we would in a normal install. All the files we need will be put in the game folder by the ReShade installer. Go to your game folder and find the ReShade DLL. It will likely be named d3d9.dll, dxgi.dll, or opengl32.dll. Rename it according to the game architecture. ReShade32.dll for 32-bit processes and ReShade64.dll for 64-bit processes. The injector is a CLI application, meaning it does not have a graphical user interface. If we double-click the injector, the CMD window pops up and closes without doing anything. That's because the injector is expecting an argument. To put it in a very simple way, a CLI application consists of three elements: the path, or where the application is located, the application that is being launched, and the arguments that interact with that application. Some applications can have dozens of arguments. The ReShade injector only takes one, that being the game executable. And to make our life easier, instead of having to run the CMD and the injector every time we want to play a game, we can write a very simple script and let the clinker handle the repetitive task. We first create a text file in the game folder. You can name it anything you want. Then add two simple commands. Start /d, and in double quotes, we put the path for the game executable. Then inject 32 or inject 64.exe, depending on the game, and the name of the game executable. Then we can copy and paste the command and just remove the inject 32 or 64 part. The first command will run the injector and tell it the name of the executable it should look for. The second command will launch the game through its executable. The /d makes sure the batch file can be run from any folder and it will always point back to the right executable. Save the changes and change the file extension from .txt to .bat. Double-clicking the file will run the injector and then the game. If the game needs to be launched through Steam, the process is a little different. On the second command, we actually have to point to the Steam executable. So the command will be start /d, and in double quotes, we put the path for the Steam executable. Then steam.exe-app-launch, and then the app ID. You can find the app ID by right-clicking the game and going to Properties and then Updates. If you have any questions about the injector or anything else ReShade related, feel free to ask for help in the comments or head to the official Marty's Mods Discord server. And don't forget you can learn more about ReShade by clicking the links in the description or watching our other videos. Thanks for joining me today, and I hope to see you next time here with Marty's Mods.